Sometimes we can seem to take things for granted, especially the things that are there all the time. But sometimes you gotta sit back and realize that some people aren't so fortunate. You know, they aren't so blessed to have someone they can talk to, somebody they can sit with and say, I'll always be there for you. I love you. I got your back. First verse.
I know you have those days when it seems like the whole world's against you. Nobody's with you. You know the days when it seems like you woke up on the wrong side of the bed and you wished you were dead. But I'm the one to pick you up when you're down. Help you get your feet firmly on the ground. See, I'm your friend when you're rich or poor. See, you'll never be alone.
Got your back,
and I'll go to the wall for you.
First met was his cousin Eric was dating my sister Rita, and his cousin Eric brought him to my house and was just like, hey, yeah, my cousin John's here or whatever, but never really introduced us, like, hey, this is Rocky, hey, this is John. So I was just like, whatever.
All right, let's see. Me and Rocky met through my cousin Eric and her sister Rita. Eric tried to introduce us and it didn't go too well. She didn't really even look at me in the car. So my opinion of her was that she was stuck up.
After that, my sister and his cousin Eric was getting a house together or whatever, and John was helping him move. And when John walked into their house, because I was in the living room, he was just like, hey, what's up, Rocky? And from there, I was just like, oh my God, who's that? So that same day, because he was over there with Eric or whatever, and I was there with my sister and playing with the kids, and I was telling my little nephew Jakari, go tell John to come here or whatever, or tell John I like him.
I ended up running into her a little later on when I was helping Eric and Rita move into their house, and I told her hello, and she seemed very excited that I knew her name. So I continued on with that, and I helped Eric finish moving and everything. And later on that evening, Rita's child, Jakari, came up to me and said Rocky wanted to see me.
I just can't stop loving you. We can change all the world tomorrow. We can sing songs of yesterday. I can say, hey, this is my life, and I want to see you for always. I just can't stop loving you. Oh, I just can't stop loving you.
If I get that,
and if I stop, oh, then tell me just what we'll do.
What will
I do? Oh, I just can't stop loving you.
My new girl,
I just can't stop loving you.
John,
that same night, I invited him to go play pool with me, but kind of blew our first date because I fell asleep. But we got back right on track because the next day I called him and we were talking from there. And probably a couple of days later, we became official.
Naturally, I went there to see what she was talking about, and she wanted to take me to shoot pool, which just so happened to be one of my favorite hobbies. So I was pretty excited about that. I said, yes, of course. And she ended up falling asleep. So our first date, she stood me up. So from then on, we exchanged numbers and we started talking, and basically turned into the relationship we're in now.
Like I'm dreaming, baby, that I found someone like you. When needed, my lover, when I'm feeling
freaking, listen to my problems when it tries to solve them.
That's so ridiculous.
Without hesitation. Well, it wasn't too long after we started dating that I felt like John was the one. So not even before we made a year, and I was like, I'm gonna marry this guy. So probably like a year and a half after we became official, he proposed to me in our apartment, and I missed the whole thing. My face was covered because I knew something was strange because he was acting a little too sweet. So I'm like, what's, you know, I'm just like, okay. And then when I saw him getting down, I covered my face and missed the whole thing, but after that, I mean, we were just inseparable. I mean, we just took it from there, getting married.
All right, so me and Rocky had been dating about a year and a half, and it was definitely pretty serious, and we were both very happy with the way it was going. And we had talked about marriage, but like I said, nobody had ever really took the initiative to actually take it to the next step. And I had a big ordeal plan for her lunch break one day, and she ended up getting off an hour early, so my big plan didn't get to come out the way I wanted it to. But needless to say, I got down on one knee and proposed to her, and realized she didn't get to see anything because she was crying and had her hands over her face the whole time. But I guess you can say once she caught her head, she said yes. Here we are, very close to the wedding day, the most important day of both of our lives. I am very happy that I get to call Rocky my wife finally after 4.5 years. She's been there through the thick and the thin, the ups and downs, so I know no matter what goes on, she's always going to be there to support me. I just want to say that, Raquel, you know, I really do love you, and I'm very excited for this day and to take this next step with you, and to move on in our life and grow old together.
It seems like forever that I have waited for you. In a world of disappointment, one thing is true. God has blessed me, and he's blessed you too. In a world of lonely people, I found you. Take my hand and hold me.
will make one. We were once strangers all by ourselves, living alone with no one else. But here you are, and it's so, so sweet. God must have done this.